Hello all, welcome to English and Beyond. So today's session will basically focus upon your first chapter of First Flight book, A Letter to God, which is written by G. L. Fuentes. Now basically he's a Mexican novelist, poet and journalist. He was also one of the leading chroniclers, that is storytellers of the Mexican Revolution. So basically he's Mexican writer. So guys, in this story we will be coming across a character known as Lencho, who is like the protagonist, the leading character of the story, and the other characters will be his wife, the postman, the postmaster, the omniscient narrator. Omniscient narrator is somebody who knows everything, okay, like he's the most reliable of all the narrators, and he will give you the most authentic side of the story. Now this story basically revolves around a character named Lencho, who's a farmer and who used to live on the crest of the mountain, of the low hill. Now what is a crest? Crest means top of the mountain or a hill. So Lencho with his family used to live on the crest. So crest is also an important word for you to remember. So he used to live with his family, and his was the only house in the entire village on that crest. So no neighbor was around him, no family was around him. His family was the only family living on that crest. And since he was a farmer, so he used to sow seeds, plow land, and his field this time was full of ripe corn. Ripe means ready to be picked corn. So it was ready for harvest, and he was eagerly waiting for the rains, because rains will turn his field into gold. This will be beneficial for his field. So he was desperately waiting for the rains, for the downpour. Okay, so as Lencho had expected, it started raining at the time of supper. So when he was having supper, it started raining all of a sudden. So supper is the last meal of the day, very light, informal one, okay. And while he was having supper, it started raining, and this made him feel very happy. He went outside, he felt the raindrops as if the sky was there were new coins were falling from the sky. So he uses a metaphor over here. The writer uses a metaphor over here by saying that raindrops were looking like as if new coins were falling from the sky. Okay. However, suddenly strong winds began to blow and hailstones started to fall. And with the rains started the strong winds and the hailstones. So hailstones are basically small balls of ice that fall like rain from the sky. So it was not only raining, but it was the strong winds also started blowing, and the hailstones also started to fall, and this continued for an hour, and corn fields were completely destroyed. Okay, the fields were destroyed due to hailstones. The field now was covered with snow like a layer of white salt, and the field was completely destroyed. It was covered with snow, and it looked as if there was a layer of white salt all over the field. So it is also like a metaphor. So now children, it's very important for us to practice to refer back to the questions for oral comprehension. So just to test our knowledge, we can practice the questions all along the chapter. So let's start with the first question. The first question is, what did Lencho hope for? So you can refer to this slide and you can pick up your answer from here also. So Lencho hoped for rains, for a good rainfall, okay, so that his fields of ripe corn would provide him a good harvest. So this is what Lencho hoped for. Now why did Lencho say the raindrops were like new coins? Why were the raindrops like new coins? The raindrops were like new coins because with rain his fields of ripe corn would produce a good harvest. So it is a metaphor. raindrops like new coins, because then the harvest would give him benefit. It will like give him good harvest, and a good harvest would help him in earning more money for his family. Okay, now the next question. How did the rain change? What happened to Lencho's fields? How did the rain change? The rain changed into hail as a strong wind began to blow and huge hailstones began to fall. So it was not only raining, but with the rain changed into strong winds, and those strong winds also brought hailstones with them. So this is how rain changed. And what happened to Lencho's fields? Lencho's fields were completely destroyed. Okay, and there was a thick layer of snow all over the fields, like a layer of white salt. Now, what were Lencho's feelings when the hail stopped? He was completely devastated, and his flowering crops were completely destroyed. So he felt that no one can help his family and they would face hunger. So what he feared was hunger, starvation for his family. He was devastated by this loss, and he thought that nothing would will bring back this loss. Okay, now Lencho had a firm faith in God. Let's get back to the story now. Lencho had a firm faith in God and decided to write him a letter for help. He asked God to send him 100 pesos. Pesos are the unit of currency in Latin American countries, like we have rupee here. So similarly, in Latin American countries, the unit of currency is pesos. So he could sow his field again. So since he was devastated, since his fields were completely destroyed by unexpected hailstones and winds, strong winds, so his only hope now left was God. So he decided to write a letter to God for help, and all he asked was for 100 pesos, which was like help his family avoid starvation, and this will also help him in giving the food to his family. So he wrote that if God didn't help him, his family would die of hunger. So children, now we can like relate the title of the story with this hope which Lencho had on God. Okay, now we can say that the title is symbolic of, a letter to God is symbolic of Lencho's faith on God. Okay, he had unwavering faith on God. So when his when the weather caused physical harm to his fields, which is like indirectly related to his livelihood, then all he is left is with his faith in God. Okay, so the title is also symbolic of Lencho's faith in God, which is like his unwavering faith in God. Okay, so in the post office, a postman found the Lencho's letter and laughed after seeing the address on it. Okay, so he writes a letter to the God, and next day, and he on that very Sunday, he goes to post office. He posts the letter, like he gives the letter to the postman, and when the postman sees the address written on that letter, he was like, he started laughing at Lencho, because he took the letter to the postmaster. The postmaster was kind and friendly person, and the postman further took the letter to the postmaster, and postmaster initially also made fun of Lencho, but then he was a kind and friendly person, and when he read the letter, he realized that the sender, that is Lencho, had true belief in God. So he decided to help the sender, that is Lencho. Okay, so to help and keep the faith of Lencho in God, the postmaster requested his employees and friends to give some money. So this time, now the postmaster, what he does is he decides to help Lencho. Okay, so he decides not to break Lencho's faith in God, and he decides to send money to Lencho to avoid starvation for his family, to avoid breaking Lencho's faith in God. So he sends money, he starts collecting money for Lencho. Okay, he gives a part of his salary. He asks his employees, his colleagues to collect the money for Lencho so that his faith can still be intact on God. Okay, so but he failed to collect 100 pesos and collected only 70 pesos. So all he could collect was 70 pesos but not 100 pesos. Okay, he then put the money in an envelope and signed it as God. What the postmaster did is he put the money in the envelope and he signed it as if it is sent by God. So now coming back to the questions, children. So who did Lencho have faith in? What did he do? So Lencho had faith in God. He believed that God sees everything and helps him. He wrote a letter to God asking him to send a 100 peso. Now who read the letter? Why did he do that? What did he do then? So the letter was read by the postmaster. What did he do then? The postmaster read the letter and then he decides to help the farmer, that is Lencho. Was Lencho surprised to find a letter for him with money yet? No. Lencho was not surprised to find a letter for him with money in it. And why, you all know. Because he had unwavering faith in God. Okay. Now next Sunday, Lencho again visited the post office, got his letter. Initially, he became happy to see the money. But after counting it, he became angry because it was only 70 pesos. So mind you guys, what Lencho had demanded from God was 100 pesos. But on seeing the envelope, the money he received was only 70 pesos. So he became angry. Okay, not unhappy, but angry. So Lencho believed that God could not make a mistake. So as you all know that he was ardent believer of God. So he thought that God could not make such a foolish mistake So it must be. So he wrote a letter again. Again writing his letter, Lencho again posted it. Okay. After writing this letter again, he posted it. As soon as he left, the postmaster took out his letter and read it. Okay. So Lencho asked for 100 pesos. He got 70 pesos. Then he got angry. He again decides to write a letter to God. Okay. This time he wrote a letter again. Again he posted it. So again the postmaster took out the letter and started reading it. In this letter, Lencho had written that he had received only 70 pesos and requested God to send the remaining money. This time Lencho is asking for the remaining money. He's saying, return the rest of the 30 pesos to me. He also requests not to send the money through the post because the post office employees were a bunch of crooks or dishonest people who might have stolen his money. So what Lencho is believing is that he's saying that don't send the money by post this time because the people who work for the post office, the people who are post office employees, they are bunch of dishonest crooks. Okay, they are bunch of dishonest people who have stolen the money. So guys, this is like kind of an end to the story. So let us revise these questions first and then we will discuss more about the story. What made him angry? Why was Lencho angry? Lencho was angry because he received only 70 pesos when he asked for 100 pesos. Okay. Next question. Why does the postmaster send money to Lencho? Why does he sign the letter God? Why does the postmaster send the money to Lencho? Because he realized the firm belief and faith of Lencho in God. He didn't want to break his faith and therefore decides to send the money to him. Okay. And why does he sign the letter as God? To maintain Lencho's faith in the Almighty. So he decides to write the letter as God. Now, did Lencho try to find out who has sent the money to him? Why? Why not? No, Lencho never tried to find out as to who has sent the money to him. Why not? Because he had unwavering faith in God. Okay, and he was like kind, he was like the ardent believer of God. So he never doubted the letter, okay, as to who has sent that letter. Who does Lencho think has taken the rest of the money? What is the irony of the situation? So Lencho thought that the rest of the money was stolen by the employees of the post office. And what is the irony of the situation? As in, what is strange about the situation, guys, is that irony is what is strange about the situation, what is like amusing about the situation, and what is opposite in the situation. The irony here is that the post office employees and the postmaster had the intention of helping Lencho, and all they got back is Lencho's hatred. Okay, they never thought that Lencho would behave in such a manner and he will doubt the intention of the post office workers. But even then, so what is the irony of the situation here, guys? Is irony of the situation is that Lencho suspects those people who helped him in his problem. Okay, instead of seeing the brighter side, instead of looking at the brighter side of the situation, all he became was pessimistic. Okay, he doubted the intentions of the people who were really kind and helpful to him. Okay, now what is the, since we have read this chapter and so what is the message that we receive from this chapter? That no matter what the situation is, one should have complete faith in God. Okay, and what are the major themes? You can see the faith of Lencho, unwavering faith of Lencho in God. Okay, you can also see the theme of hope running in this chapter, because the postmaster, the postman, they were symbol of hope for Lencho. Although they never made their feelings evident to Lencho as they by helping him, but the message of hope is quite clear by the fact that they had the intention of helping a poor man. Okay, now there's also a theme of resilience running in this chapter. Now what is resilience? Resilience is an ability to recover or adjust from misfortune or change. Now Lencho was devastated. Lencho's fields were completely destroyed. Even then he had her hope alive. Even then he thought of fighting it back. Even then he thought of overpowering his misfortune. Okay, by asking for the help from God. So this is also one of the major themes. So theme of faith, hope, resilience are all evident in this chapter. Now guys, we will continue. We will also talk about figures of speech. We will also talk about important questions which are basically like previous year questions from this chapter. So for further updates, keep tuned in. Thank you.